Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, it's Titi BJ, and I'm back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how I achieved this lovely, lovely, lovely hair from Westkiss Hair. And I have indeed worked with them before, and I absolutely love their hair. This is a 6x6 closure, not frontal closure, and I'm absolutely loving it. Like, I actually made it look like a frontal. I made it into a side part because I just felt like it would just look literally so nice as a side part. And yeah, if you guys want to see how I achieve this look, make sure you keep on watching. Hey guys, today I will be installing the 6x6 closure. This hair is from Westkiss Hair, and I'm going to start off by doing the bold cap method. So I have already applied the wig cap on, and I'm now just applying some foundation on it for it to match, you know, my skin, for the lace to melt. And now I'm just cutting the excess off, and yeah, basically just the same thing that I always do. So this is a 6x6 closure, and it's 24 inches. The lace is, I bleached the hell out of this wig. Like, I really did a good job, you know, by bleaching the knots. And I bleached the first time, it didn't really bleach as much, but then I bleached it again, and then perfect, literally. So yeah, I definitely want to do a side part wig with this. I feel like that would just look so much better, especially because it's a 6x6 closure. So now I'm just basically trying to see where and how I want to, you know, put it on my head. Having a 6x6 closure for side part is literally the best thing ever. Literally, I even feel like it makes much more sense to do, if you're doing a side part, do a 6x6 than doing a frontal, because it's just so much easier, makes life so much easier. And now I'm using my lace glue, and I'm just applying it on. And yeah, this worked really well as well. So I'm just letting it dry. Now it's dried, and I'm just applying it on. And as you can see, it's actually like skin. Like, I never really how do you call it, tint my lace, because I just can't be bothered to do that. But I definitely need to buy like lace tint, I mean the tint spray. So yeah, so now basically that bit, I'm gonna end up cutting it so it's easier for me to, you know, for it to like lay properly. But I'm just trying to press it down, so I always use a comb to like press it down, so the lace doesn't come off anymore, so the glue just sticks down properly. And as you can see, I'm just really loving it. I did also pluck it as well, so I literally did everything, pluck, bleach, and now I'm just gonna kind of comb back my edges so it's easy for me when I'm cutting the lace. Basically, when I'm cutting the lace, I like to do like zigzag, so it just looks much better. But if the lace is like really good, it doesn't really matter, but it's better anyways to do a zigzag. Now I'm just trying to cut that bit that I said that I wanted to cut out. Yeah, so it just lays flat, as you can see, just like this. It's not too bulky around there, and I'm just gonna like press it down properly. Then now I'm just gonna take some of the glue and just, you know, glue some bits that of the lace that is like sticking up. So it's definitely better to use like the back of your comb, like the thing what I'm using now, or, you know, something small so you can, you know, get in those little gaps. Use my elastic band and just use it to press down the lace so everything just sticks properly into my skin. And then after, when I finish doing that, I'm gonna take my comb and part the wig I didn't want a straight parting. I actually wanted like a C parting a little bit, but not too deep. So yeah, I parted here, but then I went in again and parted even more like at the end. So yeah, so now I'm gonna use some some mascara and just like apply it on, because as you can see I did bleach it a lot. But I feel like it's better if you over bleach it just a tiny bit, just because I just feel like it just looks more natural. And yeah, I'm now just gonna go through the hot comb, and then I'm gonna take my concealer, my old concealer, and just use that to straighten the part in a bit more. And yeah, and then I'll go in with a brush to like blend it in. So I've left the scarf on for like 10 minutes, and this is how it looks like. I'm now just gonna brush my hair, brush, just before I cut and do my edges. And yeah, I actually, like, not gonna lie, this hair is really good, and I'm really happy the outcome. I can't wait to take like videos and, you know, do my makeup. Oh, I can't wait to take more videos and more makeup looks with this hair, literally. And yeah, now I'm just putting my how much edges I want. I don't really use that much anyways, I just used a little bit. And sorry guys for my voice, I am ill, I have a cold. So sorry about that, but it doesn't matter, because this hair is the medicine, to my illness right now, okay? To my cold, because boy. So I'm using mousse. I always use mousse for my edges, so I'm just gonna use this. It's like a really strong mousse. This is from I'll list it down below, but this mousse is really strong. And yeah, so I always use this one, or I use like my olive oil mousse. The olive oil one, it's not really that strong, as in it's not really that sticky, so it wouldn't, it's more for like set, like a set, you know, like a set kind of mousse. This mousse, it's really sticky, so it proper stays, which is why I love to use it. So yeah, I'm just gonna let you guys watch how I do the rest of my edges. End results, baby girl. Ooh. Oh my god, I love the way my makeup came out, guys. I loved it so much. Like, oh, I'm definitely gonna do another video, don't worry guys. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next. Bye.